This video is going to take you through how to determine the final temperature when you have a piece of ice dropped into an amount of water that's warm. There are two outcomes that could possibly happen. The ice could completely melt, and then the water temperature would just be lowered, or the water goes down to 0 degrees and the ice partially melts. So what we have to do is we have to figure out which situation is going to happen. So for the ice to melt, you're going to use Q equals MHF. How much energy is required for the ice to melt? Well, HF is 334 joules per gram. And the amount of ice we have here is 21.5 grams of ice. So let's just multiply that out real quick. 21.5 times 334. So this would be, for all the ice to melt, we need 7,181 joules of energy. Now, the other scenario was that the water would go all the way to 0 degrees. So what we're going to do is figure out if that happens. So the amount of energy that has to be released from the warm water to bring it down to 0 degrees. So the specific heat of water is 4.18 joules per gram degrees Celsius. And it would have to drop by 76.5 degrees C. You can make it negative, it doesn't matter right now. So 125 times 4.18 times 76.5. That gives us 39,971 joules. So we don't have enough ice here to bring that down to zero. So what's gonna happen is the ice is gonna completely melt. So what you could do right here is just subtract these two. So 39,971 minus 7,181 and that's gonna equal 32,790 joules of energy left over. Now we're gonna reapply that to this equation. Now, just be sure to add the two masses. So we have our Q equals MC delta T. We have 3,270 joules. The mass is now additive, so that's 146.5 grams of melted water, the 4.18, and our delta T would be from 0 degrees now. So what we can do is we'll just bring these two numbers over. Grams and 4.18 joules per gram degrees Celsius. So we'll just divide this by 146.5 and divide it by 4.18. And the final temperature is going to be 53.5 degrees Celsius, which happens to fall between the initial temperature of the warm water and zero for the ice. So that's your TF. And that's how you figure out your final temperature when you drop ice into water.